Hello, everybody.
Hello.
How are you after all these years? Okay. One thing I'm going to warn you about is that my singing has not improved.
Hello, Jim. John.
Hello, Jim. Oh, okay. We knew you could rely on you, Jim.
Thank you.
Right, don't we? What have you done now?
As they were.
Jim, well, that's fantastic. Jim of Bude, everybody. Here's a tune dedicated to my wife, and it's called Girl of My Dreams. It's a bit cheesy, isn't it?
Thank you.
Oh yes, thank you very much. Girl of my dreams. Who was it was talking to me the other day? Yes, just yesterday, somebody was talking to me, said, do you remember those days of the Bude Jazz Festival, when it sort of years ago, 30 odd years ago, when the first session was Saturday lunchtime, the first day, whenever it was, the first day, the first session was here at 12 o'clock on the first day by the Maddocks Band. And we turned up here and we shot off very much just like we just played, and then basically realised that we had another hour or so to go. And that's exactly the same. So wonderful. We're going to play a tune now that was recorded in 1926, and it's a tune that was recorded by one of my favourite clarinet players called Johnny Dodds, and this is a tune called Papa Dip, which of course probably referred to Louis Armstrong. Papa Dip.
Thank you.
Papadip, Papadip. Well, the time has come for me to sing. I'll just check and see if I've got the words. Oh, sorry, I have. Okay, this is a tune that I think was composed by Polo Barnes, I think.
Yes, 1926.
Polo Barnes, used to play with Papa Celestin's orchestra in New Orleans, and recorded that long ago. And this is a tune called My Josephine. Are there any Josephines here? No men. See what I have to put up with. No. My Josephine. Here we are.
Thank you.
Bean. I chose a bean. So what should we do now? Let me introduce you to the band. That may be a good idea. Playing the piano, we have Keith Durston. And on the bass, we have Peter McCurrie, now on the tuba. And we're very lucky, ladies and gentlemen, to have a couple of great depths with us tonight. Band leaders in their own right. We have Pete Lay there on the drum. And Kevin Scott on banjo. There's Chris Gower over there on the trombone. Tom Connor is playing the trumpet. My name's John Maddocks. I must just tell you that in true Bude tradition, or Bude Jazz Festival tradition, the souvenir brochure just happens to have a misprint. Can you understand that? So whoever it says is playing trumpet in this band, in the programme, isn't. It's our regular trumpet player who's been playing with the band for the last 2 or 3 years, is Tom Connor. Yeah! So I don't cry. So Jim, I'm gonna have a word with you later. For the aggravation and all the heartache you've caused, it's got to be worth at least another 200 quid on the bill. Yeah. Or at least a pint. Here comes a tune, ladies and gentlemen. It was recorded by King Oliver and his band way back in 1923. And it concerns a dream. We're never going to actually find out what the dream was, but I leave that to your imagination. But whatever it was Mabel's dream.
Thank you.
my beer.
You scallywag.
It's a little tune called Papa's Got the Jim Jams. I don't think it actually refers to a nightclub singer. I think it's probably something worse than that. So, here we go then. Papa's Got the Jim Jams.
Thank you.
And this is a lovely little ballad, which I hope you enjoy. We certainly will up here, because Tom Connor is going to sing the words to this one. It's called I Want a Little Girl.
I'll do my no laughing. No laughing.
I want a little girl, as Tom has just said, I want a little girl in E flat. Once upon a time, he used to say, I want a little girl in E-flat.
Thank you.
Yeah, this is this is a tune that was written and played by a band called the Armand Perron Orchestra. It was recorded in New York in 1923. We're taking a risk here because a couple of gentlemen, in fact three gentlemen in the band, haven't played this number with us before. They're looking at bits and pieces in front of them to try and work out when they're going to stop playing, when they're going to start playing. I've got to say that the other four members of the band
don't remember.
We can't remember what to do either. So
it's jazz.
So you know we're going to attempt this season. We're all very worried about it, as you can tell. And it's a tune called the New Orleans Wiggle. Now, if anybody wants to know what the New Orleans Wiggle is, do come and ask me. But I can tell you, it's very similar to the Bude Wiggle.
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. That was the New Orleans Wiggle.
I think you enjoyed that, Nick. Yeah. It's good. You're watching.
Ladies and gentlemen, let's play one more before we take a break. And before we do that, let me tell you, there's a lady here who is walking around the United Kingdom to raise funds for an Alzheimer's charity, for the Alzheimer's charity. And she is going to come round if you want to make a contribution. There's no forcing you to do so, but she will come round during the break if you want to throw something in the pot. I'm sure it will be absolutely gratefully accepted. So she's on her way around the country. I don't know how many miles she's done so far, but the whole thing is going to be 2,500 miles. So well done to her, and we're going to take her. Thank you. So we're going to play one more and then take a break. So you can go off and see another band if you want to. We hope you're going to stay with us because the best is yet to come. Tom has just told me that. So here we are then with, I know this one will go down well in certain quarters, and it's called the Savoy Blues.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, for your company so far. We'll see you in 15 minutes' time. See you then. Thank you. If anybody's had enough people going, it's time to move. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you very much for your contributions to the charity for that lady. We're going to start off now because earlier on in the break, I was bribed to play this tune so that this lady in the audience could actually put some money in the bucket. So I'm going to live up. The lady has put the money in the bucket, so I'm going to live up to my side of the deal and play the tune. So here we go then with a little thing here called Petit Fleur. I can't remember the last time I played it, but this is where we go. request, and it's not on the list. So,
how much did they pay?
No, not sure how many, what the cost of this particular number was. I hope it was something put in the bucket, but no, you never know. This is a tune which we've actually never played together before, ever. No, we haven't. And it's a tune that was supposedly composed by Louis Armstrong. And it's a tune called, in fact, it's after his autobiography, was it? Swing That Music.
Is it an F?
Thank you.
close out this morning again. What about?
Raise that.
We probably won't play any bands. Right, we're going to do a little tune now that we need your help on. And the one thing I've got to tell you, I'm going to sing it. But I do need some help on what's called the middle eight of this tune. I know there's at least one musician here who knows what the middle eight is. This is a tune that was recorded by recorded by Joe Robichaud and his band during the 30s, and basically a swing band, but it was full of New Orleans musicians, and if you can get all those recordings, it's really worthwhile. But this is one of the tunes that they recorded, and it's called Swingy Little Thingy. Anyway, in the middle eight, you'll get the idea when I sing it to begin with, and when we sing it again, we want you all to join in, because it's very, very easy. It's in B flat again, I'm right, sorry. Okay. Is your voice alright for that?
I need to know what B-flat. To listen.
Swingy little thingy. Who was playing in a dance band, and he taught me where to find the notes on my clarinet. But in his record collection, he had a record by the Chris Barber band, and on one side, believe it or not, was Petite Fleur by Monty Sunshine. On the other side, I happen to think it was the best track I've heard by Chris Barber, and it's called The Bugle Boy March, and it's always stayed in my mind. So here we go, Bugle Boy March.
Thank you.
Thank you all very much. Talking earlier on this evening with a couple of good musician friends, and one of the highlights of my life, playing life, that is when I had the opportunity to go to New Orleans in 1980. I was still in short pants, but it was one of the highlights of my playing life, and saw some of the New Orleans greats there. And I can remember the massive excitement for a young guy standing under a street sign saying Burgundy Street Blues. I can tell you, it meant everything to me, as it did when I went and stood under the sign which said Perdido Street as well. But there you go. Anyway, I'm going to play for you now a tune called the Burgundy Street Blues.
Thank you.
means a lot. Well, ladies and gentlemen, while we're in New Orleans and Burgundy Street, let's do a tune now. We're gonna ask Pete Lay to sing this one for us. Why don't you go down to New Orleans?
Thank you.
Somebody tells me I may see him. Always got time for a couple more. We're going to play the next one only because Tom tells me he spent 3 days learning this. In the wrong key. And he just realised we've got to do it in this key. Whatever the key is. Oh my goodness. So. We're going to do a little thing here called I'm putting all my eggs in one basket. One of the reasons I'm playing this is that in 2000 and what year was it? 2004 or 6 was it? You saw the YouTube thing? Our band was filmed doing this tune here in 2004, wasn't it?
Right here.
And so I decided that we better do it. So I told Tom that we're going to do that. And he looked up our YouTube recording of this and learned it all in B flat.
Yes.
The trouble is, we're playing it in C. So here we go. I'm putting all my eggs in one basket.
Thank you.
Sadly, we have come to the last number. I'll say that again. Sadly, we've come to the last number. Did you hear a cheer from the band? We love playing for you tonight. Thank you so much for being such a great audience. We really have enjoyed ourselves. We hope you have too. What about putting your hands together, please, for Keith Durston on the piano. Thank you so much. If anybody wants to hear some more of this rubbish, we are playing at the Methodist Church tomorrow morning, round about the first session. Anyway, we're going to end on a tune here called All the Girls Go Crazy About the Way I Walk. Yes, that used to be true.
About the way you walk, you know the hardest
nice.